They are taking care of children, thousands of children, and you are paying them almost $12 million a year to do it. But are taxpayers getting their money's worth, and are the children getting the best care they can? Team 4 investigator Jim Parsons tonight. Jim.
Now, Wendy, county officials say because A Second Chance Incorporated has unique expertise, it doesn't have to compete for its contract to provide care for a majority of foster children in Allegheny County. But our Team 4 investigation uncovered document after document that raises questions about that expertise, including this report that alleges a foster child was molested by the same man who raped her a year earlier. But we start tonight with the story of baby Noah. 11-month-old Noah is one of more than 1,300 Allegheny County children placed in foster care this year. What you are about to see is Noah being removed from this home by a county caseworker. And his foster mother says it didn't have to happen.
It's been an ongoing battle with this foster care agency.
Melinda Nightingale is Noah's aunt. She agreed to take him in, but she says after 5 months, she had had enough. Not enough of Noah, but of A Second Chance Incorporated, a private foster care agency under contract with the county. Melinda says A Second Chance lost her confidential paperwork and failed to approve anyone else as a substitute caregiver. In other words, a babysitter.
They've stranded us.
So Melinda notified the county she could no longer care for little Noah. And Team 4 was there inside the home when a county social worker arrived to take Noah away.
Is this stuff together?
Yes, it is.
Okay. Is this it?
No, it's all in here.
Okay, can you please bring it, because I'm not to be on the news.
The caseworker placed Noah in a car seat and drove off.
We were forced into it. I mean, we have no backup. We have no help.
A Second Chance and Allegheny County declined to comment on Noah's case, citing privacy laws. The company has an exclusive contract with the county to handle all kinship foster care cases like Noah's, where a child is placed with a relative or a family friend instead of a stranger. Why does one agency have a monopoly on this in this county?
Well, they have acquired an expertise. They do this very well.
But state and county records raise questions about that expertise. Last month, the county controller ordered A Second Chance to refund taxpayers more than $36,000 because the agency couldn't document those costs. The company agreed to repay the funds. The report also discovered 16% of caseworkers who were checked apparently failed to get the required amount of training. A Second Chance vowed to improve its personnel record keeping. A 2009 state inspection criticized A Second Chance for drawing up required plans for children that are not very individualized, as they appear to be cookie cutter in nature and often include goals that are not applicable to the child. A Second Chance promised to retrain its staff.
We're losing $100,000 a year delivering foster care.
Until recently, Family Services of Western Pennsylvania had been providing traditional foster care for 125 years. Not anymore. Not with most foster children now being placed with family members and friends. Placements only A Second Chance is allowed to supervise.
And you were not in that business?
We're not in that business.
Why didn't you get in that business?
Well, there are probably a number of reasons over the years. More recently, we didn't get in that business because it wasn't available.
Because it is only available to A Second Chance. The agency also is not immune from allegations of children being harmed inside and outside the homes it supervises. In documents obtained from the county through an open records request, Team 4 found the following. April 2009, a foster parent reports that the child has been raped while in the care of a substitute caregiver. A Second Chance responded that it immediately dispatched a caseworker to the home for a safety assessment. June 2008, a foster child says she was raped outside the home. An agency caseworker took the child to the hospital for a forensic exam. October 2008, a foster child is molested by the same man who the report says raped her a year earlier. A Second Chance removed the child from that home. In May 2010, a Second Chance foster child was struck by a car and landed on the hood, ending up in the hospital. A county review says A Second Chance didn't find out about it for 5 days, prompting a county official to write, "This should have been reported to CYF administration immediately because of possible media involvement." Other incidents include allegations of beatings, an FBI raid of a kinship foster home where agents suspected child pornography on a computer, and the discovery of a man on house arrest for sexual assault living in a kinship foster home. A Second Chance removed those children from those homes.
Anyone that does this type of work No, there may be incidents, but we cannot speak to that. I cannot speak to those incidents at this time.
Why not?
Because the organization must, again, protect the young people, and information like that must be taken care of through the proper channels.
Late last year, Pittsburgh police arrested a former manager at a Second Chance on charges of theft and tampering with public records. The police report accused her of removing three boxes of foster care case files while still working at the agency and tossing them into this dumpster in Plumborough. The files included personal information about children. A judge agreed to enter the woman into the ARD program. Cherna says despite Team 4's findings, he won't allow other foster care agencies to bid on the contract for Kinship Foster Care.
They are very good working with relatives. If somebody has expertise and they do it well, you know, my philosophy is if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
And we are not finished. Tomorrow at 5, our Team 4 investigation exposes nepotism in this foster care agency that's funded entirely with tax dollars. We're talking about more than half a dozen relatives of the agency's CEO working there, and her husband's private for-profit company has been awarded a contract by this agency, all funded with tax dollars, most of them from Allegheny County and the state of Pennsylvania.
It strikes so many nerves on so many levels here.
Children.
Children.
Tax dollars.
Yes. All right. We'll tune in tomorrow night at 5. Thank you.
Thanks, Jim.